As of July 1st, 2023, there are currently 43 volcanoes which are actively erupting around the planet. One of these erupting volcanoes is the Ebeko stratovolcano in Russia, which is located 7 kilometers west-northwest of the Kuril Island chain's second-largest city, Severokuralsk. Ebeko is one of Russia's most active volcanoes, frequently producing intermittent volcanion to phreatomagmatic explosions which eject quantities of ash into the air. With this being said, here are this week's major volcano-related news stories. In Japan, a major earthquake storm along with volcanic tremor occurred at the Meakandake stratovolcano, marking its highest level of activity since 2018. Meanwhile, in Colombia, after 89 days of being at a raised alert level of orange, the threat of a large eruption being produced by the Nevado del Ruiz volcano largely passed in my opinion, and as a result, its alert level was lowered back to yellow. And, in the Philippines, the Taal volcano erupted for the first time in a little more than 6 months, sending a plume of ash and volcanic gases into the sky. This 250-meter-high plume had a mostly white color and was generated by 2 volcanic explosions within Taal's central crater on Taal Island. The explosion occurred on June 29th at 12:54 p.m. local time, with the eruption ending a mere 2 minutes later. However, something was unusual about this brief either VEI-0 or VEI-1 eruption. It did not directly involve any magma. As, for perhaps the first time since Taal began somewhat frequently erupting following its major January 2020 explosive eruption, the eruption was phreatic instead of phreatomagmatic. What this means is the eruption was caused by at-depth magma heating overlying rock. The overlying rock then heated groundwater, which eventually flashed to steam and exploded in what is known as a phreatic eruption. The only difference between this and a phreatomagmatic eruption is that the explosion in the case of a phreatomagmatic eruption also ejects fragments of lava. Thus, we can assume that magma is present underneath Taal at intermediate depths, as if it had instead been at shallow depths, fragments of lava would have been ejected in the latest eruption. While the sulfur dioxide emissions have seemingly dropped at Taal following this eruption, it is unclear if this was related or unrelated to the eruption. Regardless, in my opinion, more phreatic or even possibly phreatomagmatic eruptions are theoretically possible at Taal in the next few weeks. In Japan, an energetic earthquake storm struck the Mount Meakandake stratovolcano on the island of Hokkaido, which is the only historically active eruptive center within a much larger caldera which includes the volcanic cones of Mount Okan and Mount Akan Fuji. While this complex has not produced an eruption since 2008, on June 29th, beginning at 3 p.m. local time, 146 earthquakes struck underneath its most active crater known as Ponmachi-Siri Crater. This occurred alongside 2 instances of volcanic tremor. The following day, the earthquake swarm intermittently continued with 105 quakes occurring. However, on July 1st, it appears that the earthquake swarm ended as only 4 earthquakes occurred. All of this activity, in my opinion, was probably not indicative of magma movement, but rather of the movement of hydrothermal fluids, aka primarily water. I say this because gas emissions at the volcano did not notably increase during the earthquake storm, which would be expected if magma was directly involved. In Colombia, the nation's historically most destructive volcano known as Nevado del Ruiz had been at a raised alert level of orange due to the perceived elevated potential for a major eruption to occur. Its alert level was initially raised from yellow to orange on March 31st of 2023 due to an increase of thousands of seismic events each day, indicating the movement of a new batch of magma. Yet, even though this caused evacuations, it luckily did not result in a repeat major eruption or large-scale melting of the volcano's glaciers, which resulted in more than 25,000 casualties in a single 1985 eruption, as that eruption created large-scale lahars. Although Nevado del Ruiz has been intermittently erupting throughout this entire period, seismic activity, gas emissions, ash emissions, and thermal anomalies all decreased, with the earthquakes that are now occurring not indicating magma movement. As a result, Nevado del Ruiz's alert level was lowered from orange to yellow on June 27th of 2023. Here is a quick list of all the world's volcanoes which are currently erupting. Additionally, here are some volcanoes showing signs of unrest which are not erupting as of the recording of this video on July 1st of 2023. Thanks for watching. If you would like to request a specific topic, please leave a comment below. Additionally, I would like to thank this channel's patrons on Patreon and channel members on YouTube.